Hello friends, welcome to Bola English. Today, let us learn the parts of speech in English grammar. What is a sentence? A sentence is a group of words that makes complete sense, right? Let us study a sentence. Shreya came from office and hugged her little daughter lovingly. We can see that this sentence is made of 10 words. Let us look at each word. Shreya is a noun. Came is a verb. From is a preposition. Office is a noun. And is a conjunction. Hugged is a verb. Her is a pronoun. Little is an adjective. Daughter is a noun and lovingly is an adverb. Thus we can see that every word plays a different role and adds meaning to the sentence, isn't it? So each and every word in a sentence is important because words are the smaller units or parts of a sentence. They come together to form a sentence. They give meaning to a sentence. Sentences come together to form a language. We make sentences to express ourselves when we write or speak. So we can say that words are small parts of our language, parts of what we talk, that is, parts of our speech. Noun, pronoun, adjective, verb, adverb, preposition, conjunction, and interjection are called the parts of speech. Let us now see all the parts of speech one by one. A noun is a naming word. It tells us the name of a person, place, animal, or thing we are talking about. For example, Shreya, mother, Mumbai, tiger, pen, etc. Suppose we are talking about a friend, Suman. Suman is my best friend. Suman is very helpful. I meet Suman every day. Suman and I play badminton in the evening. Is this the right way of saying what we just said? No, not at all. How do we do it then? Instead, we say, Suman is my best friend. She is very helpful. I meet her every day. We play badminton in the evening. Thus we can see that we have used the noun Suman only in the first sentence. After that, instead of saying Suman every time, we have used the words she, her, and we. These words are pronouns. What is a pronoun? A pronoun is a word that is used instead of a noun. For example, I, you, we, they, he, she, his, him, her, etc. See this sentence. Suman is helpful. How is Suman? Suman is helpful. The word helpful tells us something about Suman. It gives us information about Suman. It describes Suman. Shreya hugged her little daughter. How is the daughter? She is little. The word little gives us some information about Shreya's daughter. It describes Shreya's daughter. Helpful and little are adjectives. What is an adjective? An adjective is a word that describes a noun or a pronoun. It gives us information about the noun or a pronoun. For example, tall, short, fat, thin, wide, narrow, big, small, etc. Now look at the following sentences. Shreya hugged her daughter. What did Shreya do? She hugged her daughter. I meet Suman every day. What do I do every day? I meet Suman every day. We play badminton in the evening. What do we do in the evening? We play badminton in the evening. The words hugged, meet and play in these sentences are verbs. What is a verb? A doing word is called a verb. It tells us what a noun or pronoun does. For example, play, eat, sleep, drink, read, write, etc. Now see these sentences. Shreya hugged her daughter lovingly. How did Shreya hug her daughter? She hugged her lovingly. A rabbit runs fast. How does a rabbit run? He runs fast. A tortoise walks slowly. How does a tortoise walk? It walks slowly. What do the words lovingly, fast and slowly do? They tell us how an action is done. They tell us something about the doing words or the verbs in the sentences. They are adverbs. What is an adverb? A word that gives us more information about the verb is called an adverb. For example, slowly, fast, lovingly, rudely, sincerely, softly, loudly, etc. Now have a look at these sentences. Shreya came from office and hugged her little daughter. From this sentence, we come to know two things. Number one, Shreya came from office. And number two, she hugged her daughter. These two sentences are joined by the word and. Let us see one more sentence. A rabbit runs fast, but a tortoise walks slowly. From this sentence, we understand two things. Number one, a rabbit runs fast, and number two, a tortoise walks slowly. They are joined by the word but. And but are conjunctions. What is a conjunction? A word that joins two sentences is known as conjunction. For example, and, but, yet, or, till, until, etc. In the sentence, Shreya came from office and hugged her little daughter lovingly, what does the word from do? It tells us the relation between Shreya and office. In the sentence, the book is on the table. What does the word on do? It tells us the relation between the book and the table. From and on are prepositions. A word that tells us the relation between two words in a sentence is called a preposition. For example, in, on, from, under, above, below, etc. Now look at these sentences. Hurrah! We have won the match! Oh, I was so scared! Alas, he is no more. What do the words oh, hurrah and alas express? They express a sudden feeling or emotion. They are interjections. An interjection is a word which expresses a sudden feeling or emotion. For example, oh, alas, hurrah, hush. So friends, in this lesson, we have learnt the 8 parts of speech in English grammar. In the coming lessons, we are going to see every part of speech in detail. Stay tuned. Goodbye.